friends, I'm really happy to launch the online course of the civilians today. It's really a commendable job in the current environment of not able to assemble people and have the formal classrooms. And this is the right opportunity where the civilians have taken the initiative to bring the courses online for the job seekers. And also the progress, what is achieved by civilians over the last 6 years or more is really remarkable. It has become a known entity in the state, catering to the needs of people who are coming out of the colleges and looking for jobs from various sectors. Well, one thing, the engineering job is something which one can be proud of. It's a noble profession. If you practice the conventional engineering subjects, you contribute to the nation building, and virtually you play the role of a creator. Right from the concept, evolving the design and implementation, this is a challenging job. Whether it is digging a canal or a road, or laying the railways, or building a rocket, or launching them, and commanding them. All these are really engineering jobs. I'm happy that in the country, there are several organizations which are really carrying out this kind of activities, especially the government sector, like railways, telecom departments, the R&D institutions like DRDO, the ISRO, and so on. But one deficiency what all these places have been noticing is the quality of the engineering students who are coming out of the colleges. For various reasons, the quality has suffered, and there's a large gap between the expectation of these organizations and what is delivered through the formal education. So this gap has to be bridged. That is where the agencies like civilians can play a very major role. It is just not sufficient that we learn the textbooks and the equations. But what is the relevance of that? How will you apply that knowledge to solve a practical problem? How will you participate in a project implementation, execution, quality control? All this becomes very important aspects. So this, the training, though it is for a short period, maybe varying from a few months to a year, definitely will help to enable the student community to reap the benefit. I wish all success for this venture in the coming days. Talking about the online programs, I am looking back in my days, it was ISRO which launched the first tele-education scheme way back in 2005. Those days, there was a shortage of teachers in remote village areas. And not only that, in addition to the satellite connectivity, the land connectivity has improved by orders of magnitude. That will help such program to succeed. Wish you all success once again.